This homework is to play the word game Boggle. Now, Boggle is played with a set of letters that are arranged into a grid, an n-by-n grid, here 4x4, but you should accept other sizes as well. And your task is to find all the words that can be found in this grid. Now, you can simply take ones across, so play would be a word. They don't have to go all the way across, so lay would be a word as well. And they can turn corners and go in any direction. So starting at T, we could go T-O-W. We can continue from there, A-R-D-S. And in general, we can go to any adjacent square horizontally, vertically, or diagonally. We can't duplicate. So H-I-S is a word, but we can't do H-I-S-S because S is not a neighbor of S. So his, but not his. And we could do S-I-R, but not S-I-R-S because each letter can be used only once. We can't come back and repeat on ourselves. Now I'm going to ask you to write the function Boggle Words, which takes as input a representation of the board, like this, and a minimum length of the words that count. So three-letter words at least, two-letter words don't count, so don't bother returning them. And it returns a set of words, which again are taken out of our words dictionary. Now because I'm going to pass in the board, I have to give you the representation for that. And I'm going to make a slightly different choice than I did for Scrabble boards, just to show you the range of options we have for representing two-dimensional objects like this. Now, we're trying to represent this two-dimensional array, and in Scrabble, we chose a representation like this, a nested list of lists. And so if we sign board to this list, then we can access an element with two integer subscripts like that. In our representation of Scrabble, we also made a small change so that we didn't have to worry about going off the board, which is that we introduced these border markers, the vertical bars to mean a border at the edges of every row. And we also did it, we had a top row and a bottom row, which consisted entirely of borders. So as if we took this game here and we just extended it by making a border all the way around. This 2D representation would work fine in the Boggle case, but I just want to show you another possibility, which is a one-dimensional representation, where instead of saying board sub j sub I for a position, we only have to say board sub I. And we get that representation just by concatenating together all the elements. So we take all the elements in the first row, and then add onto that list all the elements in the second row, all the elements in the third, and so on. Now we have a one-dimensional array. Now why is that better? Why is it better to have a one-dimensional array to represent an inherently two-dimensional object? Seems like a step backwards. Well, one thing is that now we can have a position in the array represented by a single object, by an integer, rather than by a pair of integers that have to be broken up to subscript into the board. So that's one advantage. And secondly, it's easier to enumerate over them. We can just say for I, S in enumerate of board. So remember, enumerate takes a sequence and returns the elements of the sequence in term. That would be the S's, the contents of each square, which would be the letters like P and L, and also an index into them, the letter, the integer I, which would be an integer 0, 1, 2, and so on. So it's easier to enumerate over the entire board in this 1D representation rather than the 2D. Both representations work fine, but I wanted to give you a little experience using this alternative. So let's do an example of this representation. Here's a simple board. It looks like that. Now we want to add on border cells, so we'll do that all around. It looks like that. Now we just put that together into a string, and so the final string would look like this. Now in terms of the indexes into the array, right here would be index number 0, and we can just enumerate them out. So it's a 5x5 array. The indices go from 0 to 24. Now let's say we want to find all the neighbors of this central square, the W. And so the neighbors would include basically all the letters here would be a neighbor of W. The index of W is 12. Now if we say that the length of a side of this matrix, we'll call that N, is equal to 5. Now if we wanted to know all the neighbors of a cell, and let's say we're looking for the neighbors of I equals 12, then it's 6, 7, 8, 11, 13, 16, 17, 18. So here's I. 11 and 13 are easy. That's I minus 1 and I plus 1. The 7 is just I minus n. The 17, I plus n. And then you can fill in the others. So you see, starting from I, it's easy to generate the 8 neighbors just by adding and subtracting n's and 1's. It's a little bit simpler doing it this way than it would with the two-dimensional representation. So here's what I'm asking you to write. This function, boggle words, given a board and a minimum length for each of the words, return a set of words. Here's some tests for you. First, the board function, and I've written that, so don't worry about it. We'll see it below. Here's a simple test. Not many words you can find in there. That should be the whole set. I've defined for you a function neighbors, which takes a square location, square number 20, in a 6x6 board, and tells you what the neighbors are. And then here's an example for play this word game. Here's the set of answers. And for this bigger board with more letters on it, there's 317 words in our small dictionary that was found. Here's our representation of board using the single string representation that I talked about. Here's a simple function to display that. It doesn't actually print it, but it returns a string, which is easily printable. And then this part, the words and prefixes, you might find very useful. That's unchanged from before.